Hello friends, in the previous session we have seen the lap winding and I have told you how the lap winding is actually wounded in a machine. Now in this particular session we'll just be continuing it and we are going to draw a 6-slot 2-pole machine which will again be double layer winding. It is just for practice. Alright, so let us start. Now here we are having our 6-slot machine. Clearly you can see there are 6 slots here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and because there are 6 slots and for each slot you are having one commutator, therefore you are having one commutator for each slot. Now because it's a double layer winding and it's a 6 slot, each slot will have 2 conductors and therefore in total you are going to have 12 conductors, and that I have already explained in the initial lectures. Alright, so let us just start naming the slots. So let me call this as my slot 1, this will be slot 2, slot 3, slot 4, slot 5 and slot 6. It's not necessary that you should name it, but still just for a reference it's okay. Now let me draw my first conductor. Now the first conductor always occupies the top slot. Okay, so this is going to be my first conductor. Okay, and I already explained it's a 2-pole machine. Alright, therefore theta electrical will be equal to theta mechanical. You can see that in the previous lecture. And I need 180 degree of theta electrical. Therefore my mechanical degree also should be 180 degree. Because the theta mechanical is 180 degree, the first coil side and the second coil side will be separated by a degree of 180 degree mechanical. Alright, so this is the first coil, coil number 1. Let me just call it as coil number 1. Alright, and the next coil side for this coil number 1, which is 1 dash, will occupy the bottom position, 180 degree. So this is 180 degree, right? And is occupying the fourth slot. So let me call it as 1 dash and it will occupy the bottom position. So if one of the coil side is occupying the top position, the next coil side will occupy the bottom position. So coil 2 top side, okay, this is coil 2 and coil 2 dash, this is not coil 2 dash, is coil 2 bottom side, which I am calling it as 2 dash. So third coil top side, third coil bottom side, fourth coil top side, fourth coil bottom side, fifth coil top side, sorry I have made a mistake here, it's not fifth coil, it's not here, yeah. So fifth coil top side, fifth coil bottom side and sixth coil top side, six, and sixth coil bottom side, which is called as 6 dash. Now let's start to connect it to the commutator. Okay, let me just mark my commutators also. So let me call it as commutator A, B, C, D, E, F. So 6 commutators are there. Now remember that there is no, I have just randomly numbered it, but there is a proper way of numbering it also based on the slot number. So that I will be discussing when I start with the developed diagram. Now we are just understanding how the lap winding are being wounded. Alright. So now let me just show you the connections with the red line. Okay, we'll show the top connections. Okay, and the connections with the yellow line will show the bottom connections. Alright, so just remember that. So this is the top connection and this will be the bottom connection. Okay, so the conductor 1 will be connected to commutator A. Okay, let me just start it by connect. So because it's a top connection, I'm using a red line. Some people, what they do is that they use the red or the same color for both, but the top connections will be a solid connection and the bottom connections will be a dotted connections. But just to give you clarity and to make the lecture fast, I am just going to use 2 colors. Okay, now one is connected to A and the other end of the coil 1, which is 1 dash, will be connected to the next commutator. Okay, which is connected to B like this. It is connected to B, and 1 dash and 2 will be connected through commutator B. Okay, so that is a top connection. So let me connect it like this. Okay, so 1 dash and 2 are connected. Now 2 dash will be connected to the next commutator to which 2 is connected. So 2 is connected to B, 2 is connected to B, so 2 dash will be connected to C, and it's a bottom connection, so I am using a yellow color. Okay, so 2 dash is connected now. The 2 dash and 3 will be connected through commutator C so that they form a loop. Okay, it's connected like that. Now 3 dash will be connected to the next commutator to which 3 is connected. So 3 is connected to C and therefore 3 dash will be connected to D. So it's a bottom connection. So let me connect it like this. Yeah, I have connected it like this. Now 3 dash will be connected to the next coil side, right? So it is coil number 4. So it will be coil number 4. So it is going to get connected like this. Okay, it is connected. Now 4 dash is the next connection. 4 dash will be connected to the next commutator as compared to 4. So 4 is connected to D and the next commutator E is E. Therefore 4 dash will be connected to commutator E. So let me connect it like this. Yeah, it's good. Now 4 dash is going to get connected to the next coil side. Okay, so which is the coil side? It is 5. Okay, so it is getting connected to coil 5. And how does it get connected? It get connected to the commutator, because commutator is a conducting element, right? So it can electrically connect these two. So let me just connect it to coil number 5, and the other side of coil 5 is 5 dash, and that will get connected to the next commutator, which is F here. So it will just get connected to F like this. Okay, 5 dash is the end of coil 5. That will get connected to the start of the next coil, and that is the coil number 6, top of the coil number 6. So let me connect it like this. Okay, and finally, because the lap winding is a closed winding, naturally the last connection will be between the coil 6 dash and the coil number 1. That is the bottom connection. So it will come like this and it will get connected. So finally the winding has closed down. So how many coils did you have here? You had 6 coils here. Okay, so you had coil number 1, which had 1 and 1 dash. Okay, so in a lap winding, the end of the one coil will get connected to the top of the next coil in the next slot. So 1 has 2 parts, 1 and 1 dash. 2 has 2 parts, 2 and 2 dash. So the connection from 1 dash will get connected to 2 through the commutator B here. Okay, and then 2 has its connection with 2 dash because it's a coil, and 2 dash and 3 will get connected through the coil commutator C. Okay, so this is how a lap winding is wound. In the next session, let us draw an 8 pole, maybe an 8 pole 4 slot machine. So you will get the difference between electrical degree and mechanical degree and how it is going to come. So I hope you have enjoyed this lecture. Please feel to share your doubts in the comment section below. So if you have liked this lecture, please like, share and subscribe this video. I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.